بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده وعلى آل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين وعلى صحابته الغر الميامين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وعنا معهم برحمتك ولطفك وكرمك يا أكرم الأكرمين قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في القرآن المجيد والفرقان الحميد شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان وقال الله سبحانه وتعالى في مكان آخر إن هذا القرآن يهدي للتي هي أقوم وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم خيركم من تعلم القرآن وعلمه صدق الله مولانا العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الأمين الكريم ونحن على ذلك لمن الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم فإن فضل رسول الله ليس له حد فيعرب عنه ناطق بفمي صدق الله مولانا العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الأمين الكريم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي ثم أما بعد Brothers in Islam, we are in month of Ramadan al-Mubarak. We are in very blessed month, a month of mercy, a month of blessings, a month of Quran, a month of forgiveness, a month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Holy Quran to first heaven, a month that in it Laylatul Qadr, Laylatul Qadr khayrun min alf shahr. And today is 11th Ramadan al-Mubarak, the second Ashara, the Ashra of forgiveness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Quran al-Kareem, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. The month of Ramadan is that in which was revealed the Quran. The Quran revealed in the month of Ramadan to first heaven. Then Sayyidina Jibreel alayhi salam, bit by bit in 23 years, revealed Quran by heart of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam in 23 years. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. The month of Ramadan is that in which the Quran was revealed. هدى للناس. The Quran is hidayah for all mankind. hudan linnas. The Quran is guidance for everyone, the all mankind. The all creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Quran is hidayah for them. And who takes benefit from Quran? The Quran is guidance for everyone. But who take the sweetness, the right guidance and the hidayah from Quran? The Quran is saying hudan lil muttaqin. The Quran is hidayah, a guidance, a true guidance for hudan lil muttaqin, for muttaqin, for those who fear from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fear means to realize Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to have idraq, to have understanding about good and bad, about right and wrong, about halal and haram, about the rulings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They have understanding from the teachings of Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So those, when they understand, when they read and understand and follow, those are those that fear from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning hudan lil muttaqin. The Quran is hidayah for those who fear from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Quran is guidance. The first thing, hudan lil nas, the Quran is guidance for everyone. But the benefit, those lucky people, they take from Quran, they fear from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the other Quran mentioned, the Quran is hidayah and the true guidance for those, liyadabbaru ayatihi, so that the wise may ponder over its verses, to think about the Quran and the verses of it. Thinking means, the first thing is that to read it, to recite it, then to see the translation and the tafasir of Quran, and after that, then follow it. So liyadabbaru ayatihi, the Quran is guidance for those who think into Quran, to think in the verses of Quran. Liyadabbaru ayatihi waliyatadhakkara ulul albab. And the Quran is guidance for those who seek direction and guidance, the true guidance, who seek and who try their best to read and understand and think. لِيَدَّبَّرُوا آيَاتِهِ وَلِيَتَذَكَّرَ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ, and seek the direction of true guidance. So Quran is hidayah for those. And anyone, any kind of thing, someone can try in it, so they can find in it, because it's mentioned in Quran, وَلَا رَتَبٍ وَلَا يَابِسٍ إِلَّا فِي الْكِتَابِ الْمُبِينِ. There is no any dryness, there is no any wetness. It means there is nothing that is not in Quran. Everything is in Quran, but it's on us that how much we give time to Quran, how much we give time to Quran to read and understand, to take benefit from it. And it's the best creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the creator is telling you, like we buy something, so there are instructions on it that you can use it like this, you can eat it like this, don't use it like this, it's going to hurt you, it's going to harm you. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is our creation, and He is the creator. And he gave us a very beautiful book, the guidance, full of guidance. And He is telling us, you can read it like this, understand it like this, give it some time. So when we follow the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's instruction, so then we can get the reward, the sweetness, and the good guidance from the Quran. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that it doesn't mean that if maybe you sometime you don't understand it, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because He is the creator, And he is saying, وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِن مُدَّقِرٍ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the Quran easy for direction and guidance. But it is there any who will take advice? فَهَلْ مِن مُدَّقِرٍ. Is there anyone that want to get advice? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it easy. But it doesn't mean that when we read we understand. But we have to give time to Quran. When we give time to Quran, then we understand it. Then we have to think about it. Then we follow it. So then we can get a good guidance from it. And also the Quran is shifa. وَشِفَاءٌ لِمَا فِي الصُّدُورِ. The Quran is saying, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ قَدْ جَاءَتْكُمْ مَوْعِزَةٌ مِّنْ رَبِّكُمْ وَشِفَاءٌ لِمَا فِي الصُّدُورِ وَهُدًى وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. The Quran is guidance, maw'iza, nasiha, advice from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, min rabbikum, wa shifa'un lima fi suduri. And the Quran is cure for those diseases which are hidden in our breasts, in our chest, in our hearts. And the Creator is telling, wa shifa'un lima fi sudur. If you want to remove the diseases from your heart that are hidden, so you can remove them with Quran. وَشِفَاءٌ لِمَا فِي الصُّدُورِ. And the Creator is telling that the disease, the cure of diseases is in Quran. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ قَدْ جَاءَتْكُمْ مَوْعِزَةٌ مِّنْ رَبِّكُمْ وَشِفَاءٌ لِمَا فِي الصُّدُورِ وَهُدًى وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And it's a hidayah, a guidance, and also it's a blessing and rahmah for mu'mineen, for believers. So these are the things that we can understand and read and give time to Quran. If maybe someone doesn't have knowledge and don't want to read or understand and follow the Quran, but at least minimum to recite the Quran. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in many ahadith, there are chapters in every book of hadith about the virtues of Quran, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is encouraging us. At least if you don't want to understand it, if you don't want to do tadabbur and think in about Quran, but at least you have to recite it. That will give you benefit in this world and hereafter as well. In hadith of Bukhari, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من كرع حرفا من كتاب الله فله به حسنة. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever recites a letter from Allah's book, فَلَهُ بِهِ حَسَنَةٌ, then he receives the reward from it. وَالْحَسَنَةُ بِعَشَرِ أَمْسَالِهَا. The reward is like a 10 rewards. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is mentioning more, لَا أَقُولُ أَلِفْ لَا مِيمْ حَرْفٌ وَلَكِنْ أَلِفٌ حَرْفٌ وَلَامٌ حَرْفٌ وَمِيمٌ حَرْفٌ. I don't say the alif, lam, meem is a one letter. Alif is a different letter. Lam is different. And the meem is different. So you will get each letter 10 rewards. That you recite Quran from each letter 10 rewards. And it's giving us examples that don't think that maybe the one word is one letter. One word has different letters. 5 letters, 6 letters, on each letter you can get reward. مَنْ جَاءَ بِالْحَسَنَةِ فَلَهُ عَشَرُ أَمْسَالِهَا. When you get one reward, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to multiply it with 10. So you can get 10 rewards. This is for those they doesn't want to understand, but at least recite Quran. And especially in this month, شَهْرُ رَمَضَانَ الَّذِي أُنزِلَ فِيهِ الْقُرْآنِ. This is the month of Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed Quran in it. So this month is for with Quran. We should make friendship with Quran and try our best to read more than more to get reward in this world and hereafter. And the Creator and the Messenger both are telling and guiding and teaching us to recite, read, understand Quran, to make friendship with Quran, because everything is in Quran. وَلَا رَتَبٍ وَلَا يَابِسٍ إِلَّا فِي الْكِتَابِ الْمُبِينِ. In another hadith, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ وَعَلَّمَهُ. The best of you is who learns the Quran and teaches Quran. And the Ravi, the narrator of this hadith, Abdul Rahman al-Sulami, he said, when I hear this hadith from one companion, so right away I started reading Quran and then teaching Quran until the time of Sayyidina Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and until the Hajjaj bin Yusuf came. The time of Hajjaj bin Yusuf came, till that time I was just sitting, reading and teaching the Quran. Because when I hear the Prophet, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is giving guarantee, خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ وَعَلَّمَ, the best of you is who learns the Quran and teaches it. So it's that kind of thing, that if you read it, those people are the best people. Also the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioning in another hadith, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن لله أهلين من الناس, Allah has his own people among mankind. قالوا يا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من هم, the companions asked, oh the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, who they are? The messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, هم أهل القرآن أهل الله خاصته, the people of the Quran, the people of the Allah, those who are closest to him. And who recite the Quran, they are closest, they are people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that much Allah subhanahu, because it's the book of Allah. If you read someone's book here in this world, so that, you know, you become inspired from him, and also you think about him and you be closest to him. So when we read the best book, the best creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the book of Allah, the full of guidance, the full of blessing, the full of knowledge, for not just the Sharia, not the Islamic things, anything you can, وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِن مُدَّكِرٍ, any kind of thing you want to find in Quran, you will find, because وَلَا رَتَبٍ وَلَا يَابِسٍ إِلَّا فِي الْكِتَابِ الْمُبِينِ. In another hadith, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, يَقُولُ بِئْسَمَا لِلرَّجُلِ أَن يَقُولَ نَسِيتُ سُورَةَ كَيْتَ وَكَيْتَ أَوْ نَسِيتُ آيَةَ كَيْتَ وَكَيْتَ بَلْ هُوَ نُسِيَ. This hadith is related with Huffaz, or those they memorized Quran or some parts of Quran. If someone asks them that can you read this part, they say we forget it, or maybe I don't know it, I forgot it. Say, don't say that you forget it, but you should say بَلْ هُوَ نُسِيَ, but he has been made to forget, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take it from them. Those who memorize, after that they don't read it again and again. So don't say that we forget it, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take it from them. But he has been made for it. بَلْ هُوَ نُسِيَ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made him to forget it. So anyone recite Quran and forget it, try to their best to memorize it again and put an effort. So when they put an effort, وَأَلَّيْسَ لِلْإِنسَانَ إِلَّا مَا سَعَى, when you try for anything, so you will get it. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Kareem, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Rahim, and His mercy is more than anything. So when we try for anything, Allah, especially for reciting the Quran or memorizing Quran, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us with the barakah of Quran. And also in another hadith, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا تجعلوا بيوتكم مقابر, don't make your houses like a grave, that you should recite Quran in your houses as well. He is giving tashbih and example, that don't make your houses like a grave. وَإِنَّ الْبَيْتَ الَّذِي تُقْرَعُ فِيهِ الْبَقَرَةُ لَا يَدْخُلُهُ الشَّيْطَانِ, if someone reads Surah Al-Baqarah in their house, the shaitan doesn't enter in their house, with the barakah of Surah Al-Baqarah. So that much it has barakah. In another hadith, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ لَيْسَ فِي جَوْفِهِ شَيْءٌ مِّنَ الْقُرْآنِ كَالْبَيْتِ الْخَرَبِ, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the one who does not have the Quran inside him, in his heart, كَالْبَيْتِ الْخَرَبِ, is like the ruined house. Like, we should memorize some parts of Quran, and here the saying that someone doesn't have in his heart the parts of Quran, the ayats, the verses, the surahs of Quran, kal baytil kharbi, is like the ruined house. So these kind of examples the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is teaching us and guiding us that we should at least recite Holy Quran. If you don't understand it, but at least we can get rewards and barakah in this life and hereafter, and especially in this month. This month is the month of Quran, Shahru Ramadan Alladhi Unzila Fihi Al-Quran. So this month is the month of Quran. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us tawfiq to make friendship with Quran, to seek guidance from Quran. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us tawfiq to recite Quran, how much we can, even if we don't, if we are not able to recite, at least we can listen Holy Quran to take all the benefits from Holy Quran.